dry. Once you have your masterpiece finished and it's thoroughly dried, some people recommend 3 weeks drying time just to be on the safe side, you can hang your piece on the wall or sell it, and that's that. Beautiful. I like to take mine one step further. I like to put a layer of resin on the painting. You can see this painting here has a very clear, hard, glossy finish to it because I've gone through the process of putting resin on it. Epoxy resin is a liquid that comes in two parts. One is the resin, the other is the hardener. You mix them equally by volume, not by weight. And when it's cured, you've added an incredibly beautiful protective element to your piece. My favorite thing about using resin is the fact that it brings acrylic pour paintings back to life. When a painting is wet, in my opinion, it looks the best it will ever look. With pouring resin on a finished painting, the colors seem to pop and look as if they've been frozen in time while still wet. It really elevates a piece from something cool hanging on the wall to something of a showpiece. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I resined this piece. There's a checklist of things I go through before I start any resin project. One, I make sure that my work surface is level and that it's covered with a layer of plastic. Once resin cures, it's on there for good. So make sure that your surface is covered with something disposable or plastic, as resin has a tendency to not stick to plastic bags once it's cured. Two, I always support my canvas in the center. I cut cardboard to fit inside of the frame of the canvas so that the canvas has some support in the middle. Resin is heavy, so it will tend to collect in the center of the painting and make the canvas bow in the middle if it's not supported, especially a larger canvas like this one. Three, I elevate my piece off of the table. Your resin will bond your painting to the work surface if it's not elevated in some way. Four, I wear gloves, and you should wear a mask or respirator, especially if your workstation isn't well ventilated. The resin I use is non-toxic, but the smell can become a little overwhelming if you're applying resin in a poorly ventilated environment. Now keep in mind, you don't have to have a resin tent like the one I constructed in my previous video and that you'll see in this video. All you really need is a box or some type of covering to place over, not touching the wet resin while it cures. The purpose of covering the resin is to cut down on the amount of dust and hair and foreign objects that might collect and become part of your work in the cured resin. All right, with all of those things in mind, here is how I put resin on this piece. Hi, so welcome to the inside of my resin tent. It's weird, right? Yeah, I know. I've gone through my entire checklist, all set and ready to go. This is my resin. So as you can see, there are two lines. That's the hardener or the resin itself. And for this particular painting, it's a 20-inch by 20-inch painting. I needed a total of 14 ounces total. So that's 7 ounces of one, 7 ounces of the other. I've cleaned it off. We're pretty dust free, and here we go. And I like to pour it towards the edge as well. The same way I actually put on the base coat for a painting when I'm gonna do a painting. I kind of focus on the edges because I know that it's gonna end up in the middle eventually. It's a little harder to get it to the edges. This is the first layer. So this is going to be the, let's just get things on here and see how it covers layer. So you're gonna go over the side. I don't know if you can see this on there, but I'm actually pushing it over the edge. Some people prefer to dome the resin, pushing the resin up to the edge of the painting, but you're not allowing it to go over the side. I don't care for that so much. This painting for me is all about liquid and all about how things flow and the movement of things. I actually prefer the drips that appear along the sides. That's part of the charm for me. I enjoy that a lot. And it's random, it's something that I don't control, and I kind of like that. The cardboard is really helping out keeping everything level because the resin is very, very heavy. And if you didn't have a piece of cardboard on a canvas this size supporting it in the center, you would get a very, very thick layer of resin in the middle, and it would be thinner on the sides. So I've done a pretty good job of covering it. I'm gonna look at it in the light.
And the cool thing about this resin also is that it self-levels. So if you do end up missing a spot, which you shouldn't because you should check it out in the light, you should have a light source that at least reflects a little bit on your painting so you can see exactly what you're doing. It will fill in the gaps for the most part, unless there is some element of oil or grease that will prevent the resin from actually sticking. So I'm gonna get rid of my stick for a second, and I'm just gonna go over the sides with my hands to make sure that I can feel that the resin has coated the sides of my painting. Coating the sides also, I find, helps when I do the second layer, because the second layer, as you'll see, I like to put a piece of painter's tape around and build a dam. I'll explain all that later when I do the second layer. If you have a layer of resin on the sides of the painting, the painter's tape will stick to the resin and come off very cleanly, as opposed to trying to get the painter's tape off of just the painted canvas. Sometimes the painter's tape, no matter how weak the painter's tape is, it will rip the sides of the canvas right off and the paint will come right with it. It's pretty well covered. And I'm not sure if you can see this right now, but there are a ton of bubbles, just a ton of bubbles. I'm gonna use this to pop out the air bubbles. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see that or not, but that's what this process is. Really important to pop the air bubbles out of the resin at this point, because if you wait longer, adding any direct heat to the drying resin will cause it to malform. There will be visible lines and distortions in the finished resin layer. So you want to make sure that you're doing this part of the process now. Awesome. I think that's pretty good. There are some little specks of dust in there, so I'm going to remove those now. And again, this is self-leveling. The resin will correct any little divots that I take out because of the dust pieces that I remove from the surface. You will end up doing a second layer, maybe not as thick as the first layer. So this layer doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be completely dust-free, because you're gonna scratch up the surface of this layer so that your second layer sticks. And that's it. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wait 1 hour. I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna look at the surface again in the light to make sure that there aren't any dust pieces that have fallen in after I've left. And after that, I'm gonna be done. I'm gonna let this cure for an entire 24 hours before I take it out of the resin tent. It's 24 hours later, and my first layer of resin is cured to the touch. Let me show you exactly why I need to do a second layer of resin. So generally, it looks really nice. It looks really, really good. The coverage seems pretty great until you get to places like this. You can see the reflection of my tripod. It shows that it didn't quite cover in that one specific area. So there's a big bare spot, which is not exactly the look you're going for. And if I move the camera around, you'll probably be able to find a few more. Yeah, towards the edge down here, you can see that there are some more bare spots right there on the very, very edge. So that's a reason that I'm going to need to do a second layer of resin on this particular painting. Before I can put on my second layer of resin, I need to prep the canvas first.
Side note, I take the painting out of my resin tent for this next step.
And that step involves sandpaper. So the painting is going to go from looking like this to this.
Another side note, after I sanded the painting, I cleaned off the surface, wiped it down with glass cleaner just to remove any fingerprints or leftover resin bits, dried it off, and then continued on with these next steps.
As you can see, it is no longer a glass-like smooth finish. It is all scratched up from the sandpaper. There are a couple of reasons that you use the sandpaper. One is to buff out any imperfections that you may have missed in the first layer. So if there are any dust particles that land in it or any bubbles that you didn't manage to get out the first time around, buffing it with the sandpaper really eliminates all of those imperfections. The second reason you use sandpaper is to give the second layer of resin some tooth. It's going to give it something to hold on to. Instead of pouring onto a very smooth, flat, glass-like surface from the first layer, Now that I've gotten all of these scratches and grooves created, the second layer has something to hold on to. So the bond between the first layer and the second layer of resin will be much, much stronger. You'll also notice that I put a layer of painter's tape around the outside, and that is to essentially dam up the resin to keep it inside to make sure that all of those grooves and all of those bare patches from the first layer will be completely covered by the second layer. I'm not going to use as much resin as I used the first time. I'm only going to use 10 ounces. So that's 5 ounces of the resin, 5 ounces of the hardener, because I don't need as much. I don't need such a thick coating for this second layer. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the resin on. I'm going to check for any dust or bubbles. And then I'm going to come back an hour later, check for any dust or bubbles. And then I'm going to come in 2 hours later and remove this painter's tape, which will then allow the resin to slowly, slowly, slowly creep over the edges of the painting and create this rounded corner instead of a very sharp 90 degree angle. It will create this really nice smooth edge on the top and sides of the canvas. So I will show you what it looks like in 24 hours.
Full disclosure, I had to do a third and final layer of resin on this piece because there was one very stubborn bare spot that had a hard time taking the resin. I followed the exact same steps that I did between layers 1 and 2 in the segment you just watched, and this is what I ended up with. As I mentioned earlier, putting resin on your work is such a beautiful and protective element. Let me know if you've tried it and if you have any additional tips that have worked for you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.